Oh, no way. We gotta get out of here. So after spending the last 2 weeks in this atmospheric river and then 2 weeks up in Washington where it was raining for 2 weeks there too, we decided we had to get out of here. When you crest the top of Ranchita, you get a great view out into the desert. You can see what is to come. We see blue sky.
Oh, it's 11 o'clock. It's past 11 o'clock. What does that mean?
That means lunch.
Tyson doesn't miss lunch.
So our goal today was to see a couple of areas that we hadn't been into before. One being Fonts Point and the other one being Buttes Pass. So after airing down and disconnecting the sway bar, going for the smoother ride today, we were on our way. Hiking again.
The Borrego Badlands are severely eroded sedimentary rocks laid down by the same ancient Colorado River that gouged out the Grand Canyon.
This Fonts Point is incredible. The video just does not do it justice. We've been looking up at this from Ocotillo Wells for 30 years, and it just looks like lines in the sand and the mountains. But then when you get up there and see the cliff, it is amazing. Guys, if you ever get a chance to get out there, do it.
The camera's not gonna do it justice at all.
No, you can't even see how far down that is.
Thank you.
So over there where the sun's coming through, that's where the narrows come out of the mountains, going out to Ocotillo.
Mm-hmm.
And if you come this way, this is going to be Butte Wash that we're going to get in. And that black mountain over there, that's the backside of Blow Sand. Behind that, the tall mountain, that Split Mountain. And that black mound right there, out there, that's Devil's Slide. And Shell Reef's over there on the left. And way, 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 way back there in the back, that's Superstition. And over here on the left is Salton Sea. It's way out there.
We actually can't even see it in the camera. Oh, maybe you can. There's Salton Sea way out there. My eyes are so weirded out looking. The Badlands of the Anza-Borrego Desert State Park are now amongst the driest places on Earth.
So after heading out of Vaughn's Point, looking north towards Rock House Canyon there, you can see that the rain is coming over the mountains. Forgot to mention, you can get up to Vaughn's Point with two-wheel drive, especially after a rain when the sand's hard. Probably four-wheel drive if the sand's really soft, but it's an easy run to get up to Vaughn's Point. So we're transitioning over from Vaughn's Point back over towards Palo Verde Wash and Ocotillo Wells. And there was another vista, which I can't pronounce. I'll let Julie do that. That we decided to jump up to, and it was really cool. It was just another view back on the Vaughn's Point.
Vista del Mal País. View of the rough and barren landscape.
It's Vaughn's Point over there.
It still does just not do it justice in a camera.
It's gonna rain.
On us?
Yeah.
We
Look at that. It's getting closer. Run.
Oh.
Okay, we're filling some sprinkles out here. I think we're going to get caught in a torrential flood out here in the desert.
Look at the news.
Run for the car.
So we're driving along and we see the shiny stuff all over these hills. You can see it up there. It's all shiny. Oh, I got a piece. What is it, Julie?
I think it's calcite.
We think it's calcite. So we followed Fault Wash down to Cut Across Trail, but going west this time, which I've never gone west, and over to Buttes Canyon. You can kind of see in the video that we're looking back at the Fonts viewpoint, but from down south on the Ocotillo side. The terrain really changes here in Buttes Canyon. The trees start to get bigger down in the wash. And then there's these really peculiar green rocks up on the hillside that you can see and that we get closer to eventually. We're trying to figure out what that was all about. It was really interesting. There were some people kind of camping and stuff up here in these canyons. They're really secluded, pretty neat area. So we cut across to Buttes Pass and to Slot Canyon Trailhead, where we come down right here. Not really sure if this side is called Slot Canyon or not, but really cool, nice hikes out here. And we drove around to the drop-off, which is a pretty good drop-off. It's a little steeper than Diablo Drop. And some bigger holes, but still fun nonetheless.
after playing around on the slot here, drops down into a really neat little tight canyon. Some light rock crawling and pretty narrow for a full size, but kind of fun to slow down and just crawl around a little bit rather than the wide open desert. And we took this back out to the San Felipe Wash. So we ran San Felipe Wash right down to the backside of Blowsand into Blowsand Canyon, which I've never been up. Kind of comes up on the backside. You can see the sand just stacked up into the mountainside here, just like Blowsand, but on the opposite side. Super neat little canyon that comes up really narrow, soft sand. Not difficult, but really neat to see. Well, we aired up and headed back to the highway, picked up Highway 78, and started heading home. Well, we can see the rain on the mountain. Looking west to home, we know what's to come. We definitely need the rain, but we also need to get out of here sometime and just enjoy the day. Well, we wish some of you guys could have come on today's run with us. Until next time.